Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at DutchPod101.com.
10 questions you should be able to ask and answer in Dutch. We have a lot of ground to cover, so let's get started. The first one. Hoe heet u? Hoe heet u? What's your name? An answer to this could be Ik heet Jacob. Ik heet Jacob. My name is Jacob. So this is just your basic introduction, but an important thing to remember is that the Dutch word u is very formal. So if you want to ask a coworker or a classmate or someone who is the same age as you what their name is, you should probably say je instead of u. So it would be hoe heet je? Next question. Hoe gaat het? Hoe gaat het? How are you? And an answer might be Met mij gaat het goed. Met mij gaat het goed. I am doing well. Now this is a pretty long sentence that you don't necessarily need to, you know, say in full. If someone asks, hoe gaat het? You can just shorten it and say, goed. Waar kom je vandaan? Waar kom je vandaan? Where are you from? Sample answer, ik kom uit Amsterdam. Ik kom uit Amsterdam. I am from Amsterdam. Now, if you're just asking this question flat out, then people might consider that to be a little direct. So a more gentle way of asking this is just assuming that someone is from somewhere and then letting them correct you. So you could ask, kom je uit Amsterdam? Which means, are you from Amsterdam? And then someone else could say, no, actually, I'm from Haarlem. Hoe oud ben je? Hoe oud ben je? How old are you? Possible answer, ik ben 20 jaar. Ik ben 20 jaar. I am 20 years old. So if you're answering this question, you may actually leave out jaar. You can just say, ik ben 20, and leave it at that. That's more common. Waar werk je? Waar werk je? Where do you work? Ik werk in Rotterdam. Ik werk in Rotterdam. I work in Rotterdam. Though this sample answer is a city, you're more likely to get an answer with something like, I work in marketing, or I work at Coolblue, or whatever. So when you're asking someone where they work, it's assumed that you're talking about the job, not the actual location. Here's an opportunity to learn some numbers. Wat is je telefoonnummer? Wat is je telefoonnummer? What is your phone number? Answer. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345-6678. Mijn telefoonnummer is 012-345-6678. My phone number is 012-345-6678. So now you also have an idea of all the numbers from 0 to 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hou je van Nederlands eten? Hou je van Nederlands eten? Do you like Dutch food? A likely answer to this is nee, ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. Nee, ik hou niet van Nederlands eten. No, I don't like Dutch food. So some typical Dutch dishes are hutspot, which is mashed potatoes with mashed carrots, and beschuit met muisjes, which is like a crispy biscuit with small pink or blue and white little balls on it, and they're made of sugar and aniseed. And that's traditionally eaten at the birth of a child. Well, to celebrate the birth of a child. Heb je broers of zussen? Heb je broers of zussen? Do you have any brothers or sisters? And an answer to this may be, ja, ik heb een broer. Ja, ik heb een broer. Yes, I have one brother. So there's no real Dutch equivalent to the word siblings, so you'll always have to ask if they have brothers or sisters. It can be a little bit of a pain, but there's just no alternative, so sorry. Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Ben je wel eens in Nederland geweest? Have you ever been to the Netherlands? A likely answer. Nee, ik ben er nog niet geweest. Nee, ik ben er nog niet geweest. No, I haven't been there yet. Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd? Waar heb je Nederlands geleerd? Where did you learn Dutch? It's so incredible. Sample answer would be, ik heb het op school geleerd. Ik heb het op school geleerd. I have learned it at school. I don't actually know if there is any country except for the Netherlands where they teach Dutch. We're not very popular in that sense.
10 Dutch phrases you always want to hear. I am Stella and I will be giving you a lot of compliments today. Have fun. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great. Let's start with, je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great today. Always nice to hear, right? Don't use it too often, you don't want it to lose its meaning. Ik mis je. I miss you. This next one is rather sad. Ik mis je. Ik mis je. I miss you. As you can hear, the Dutch and English version of this are very similar, so it's easy to remember. You usually say this when you're on the phone with someone, in other words, when they're not actually there with you. Or you say it about someone else. You could say, for example, ik mis mama. I miss mom. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. This is a nice one if you want to tell someone they did well. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. You can also shorten it to goed gedaan or goed zo, meaning good job. It's a little more casual that way. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There's a bonus at the end of the month. So nice to hear. Sadly, it doesn't happen as often as we'd like. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So imagine you've gone to dinner at a friend's place and the food was great. You could say, je kunt erg goed koken. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So if the food wasn't really good, but you still want to be polite, but you also don't really want that person to ever touch a pan or a stove again, you can say, dankjewel voor het koken. Thank you for cooking. This is still very nice, but you don't have to actually say that dinner was amazing. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Isn't that nice when someone tells you to just sit down and relax for a while? Maybe try using it today and say it to someone. You're sure to make some friends that way. En jij wint. And you win. So this is what you say at the end of a game. En jij wint. En jij wint. And you win. You can also say it to end an argument if you feel that maybe the other person was right after all. You can say, all right then, you win. Vooruit dan maar, jij wint. It will get you some points to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. You were right. This next one is also great to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. Je had gelijk. You were right. Feel free to say this to me anytime. I don't mind. I really don't. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, imagine you've taken a long trip and you have brought a special gift home with you for your sister, who is Dutch. You can give it to her and you can say, ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, please don't say this if it's just a t-shirt with the Eiffel Tower on it. Really save it for when you really picked out something special for your sister. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This one is really nice if you're planning a party and you want to hire a fire breather, but you're not sure if that's too expensive. And you ask that to someone, is that too expensive to hire a fire breather? And they say, het budget is onbeperkt. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This means go ahead with the fire breather and make sure everyone has their own personalized cocktail. This party is going to be great.
Some different phrases that you can use to amaze native speakers of the Dutch language. Are you ready? Let's go!
Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually.
After this class, people automatically assume that you're a native speaker, and then you can baffle them with this sentence. Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Dank je, maar eigenlijk ben ik geen native speaker. Thank you, but I'm actually not a native speaker. So make sure this comes out completely fluent, because you don't want to ruin the effect. So did you notice that the Dutch verb for native speaker is just native speaker borrowed from the English? That ought to make it a little bit easier for you.
Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. It only took me 1 year to become fluent.
Next sentence. Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. Ik had maar een jaar nodig om er fluent in te worden. And this means, it only took me 1 year to become fluent. Now don't feel bad if this is not true. Dutch is a notoriously difficult language to master, so it would probably take anyone more than a year.
Ik spreek in 3 jaar tijd Nederlands als een native speaker. I'll speak Dutch like a native speaker in 3 years.
This one is a touch more realistic. Ik spreek in 3 jaar tijd Nederlands als een native speaker. Ik spreek in 3 jaar tijd Nederlands als een native speaker. So this sentence is said like it's like a New Year's resolution, right? So if you want to say that it has already happened, then you should use the past tense. So you would say, ik sprak in 3 jaar tijd, instead of ik spreek.
Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. I've been learning Dutch for 10 years.
This next one is for everyone who feels that it's going to take some more time. Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. Ik ben al 10 jaar Nederlands aan het leren. I've been learning Dutch for 10 years. So to be honest, even native Dutch speakers make mistakes. I've been learning Dutch for 27 years. It's a hard language, guys, so don't feel bad.
Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. I can watch Dutch movies without subtitles.
Here's one that's a true accomplishment, and it's within reach. Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. Ik kan Nederlandse films zonder ondertiteling kijken. And this means, I can watch Dutch movies without subtitles. Now the only question remaining is, why would you want to watch Dutch movies? I'm just kidding. There's one movie that I really do like and can recommend, and it's called Minus. The story is by Annie M. G. Schmid, and it has Carice van Houten in it. So it's a really great movie. It's about a woman who's actually a cat, I think.
Ik kan ongeveer 50 nieuwe Nederlandse woorden per dag onthouden. I can memorize around 50 new Dutch words a day.
Next phrase. Ik kan ongeveer 50 nieuwe Nederlandse woorden per dag onthouden. Ik kan ongeveer 50 nieuwe Nederlandse woorden onthouden. I can memorize around 50 new Dutch words a day. So if that's really true, then I applaud you. 50 words is a lot to remember in 1 day.
Nederlands is leuk en makkelijk te leren. Dutch is fun and easy to learn.
Nederlands is leuk en makkelijk te leren. Nederlands is leuk en makkelijk te leren. Dutch is fun and easy to learn. Now, to be completely honest, I don't agree with this. I feel it's disheartening to say that any language is easy to learn. I mean, sure, we're trying to make it as easy as we can for you, but it takes a lot of hard work, and also it really depends on what language you're coming from. Like, if you already speak German or something, it'll be a lot easier. However hard or easy you think it is, go you, and you're doing great.
Naast het Nederlands kan ik ook nog een paar andere talen spreken. Apart from Dutch, I can speak a few other languages as well.
Naast het Nederlands kan ik ook een paar andere talen spreken. Naast het Nederlands kan ik ook een paar andere talen spreken. Apart from Dutch, I can speak a few other languages as well. So if you're watching this, you at least speak English fairly well. and probably a little Dutch by now. So good job. And if you don't feel that that's enough, I can recommend Swedish. It's a pretty language.
Ik leer Nederlands helemaal zelf. I'm learning Dutch all by myself.
Ik leer Nederlands helemaal zelf. Ik leer Nederlands helemaal zelf. I'm learning Dutch all by myself. If you are, don't do that. The key to any language is communication, and really listening and speaking with others would really help you learning this language. So whenever you can, try to practice your listening and speaking skills with a buddy who's also learning Dutch, or even better, with a Dutch native speaker. So studying by yourself is impressive, but learning with a friend is faster and more fun. So try to find someone to study with.
Ik begreep alles van wat je zei. I completely understood everything you said.
Now, if things are going really well and someone is unsure about your Dutch skills, you can say this. Ik begreep alles van wat je zei. Ik begreep alles van wat je zei. I completely understood everything you said. So Dutch people will switch to English when they think that maybe it's easier for you. So to prevent them from doing that, make sure you can say the sentence so you can practice your listening skills and speaking skills too, maybe.
Want to finally start speaking in your target language? In this guide, you'll discover the top 7 ways to practice speaking on your own with our lessons. Let's begin. Number 1, shadowing. Shadowing is a proven learning technique where all you do is repeat what you hear in order to practice speaking. So access any audio or video lesson on the site and press the play button to start. Then, as you listen or watch, just repeat the conversations. Or even easier, read along out loud with the dialogue section. The script is right there in front of you. With our lessons, you can master entire conversations just like that. Number 2, read out loud. I just mentioned it, but reading out loud is another powerful tactic and deserves its own mention. With every lesson, you get written transcripts and translations. So as you play the lesson, read the dialogue out loud as you hear it. Why? By reading out loud, you're also practicing your speaking skills. You can do this with the lesson notes, the lesson transcript, or the dialogue tool. With the dialogue tool, you can listen to each line again and again and repeat out loud until you master them all. Number 3, speed up your reading to speed up your speaking. Being able to speak without thinking is a sign of language mastery. If you're talking to a native and can respond quickly, they'll assume that you're fairly fluent. How can you do this? When you read out loud, try increasing your speed a little bit every time. So, start by reading with the dialogue tool. If you're like most learners, you'll read the first line slowly. That's because you're still getting used to the words, which is okay. Reread it. On your second try, you know most of the words, and you'll read a little faster. Reread it again. On your third try, you'll be even faster, at a native speaker's speed. And being able to read these phrases out loud and fast will help you speak fast. Number 4, record and compare yourself with native speakers. In order to sound like a native speaker, you must imitate native speakers. So here's how. Access the voice recorder, which is in the dialogue study tool in every lesson. Click on the microphone icon, listen to the native speaker's audio, and then record yourself. You can then compare the two recordings side by side and practice and try again and again until you perfect your pronunciation. Number 5, get feedback from our Premium Plus teacher. If you're learning by yourself and don't have access to real teachers, then you can always get feedback from our Premium Plus teachers. With the My Teacher tool, you can record yourself speaking and send the audio file to the teacher. They'll review it and tell you what to improve and how. That's it. Number 6, level up your speaking with Premium Plus assignments. With Premium Plus, you can also get assignments that cover reading, writing, listening, and even speaking from your teacher. These assignments can be tailored to your goals and needs. You get a new one every week, or anytime you're ready for a new one. Number 7, get even more lessons in the lesson library. If you want even more lessons on speaking and conversations, visit our lesson library and under category, choose conversation. You'll get all of the pathways and lessons that are focused on speaking. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share it with anyone who's trying to learn a language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. And if you're ready to finally learn language the fast, fun, and easy way, and start speaking from your very first lesson, get our complete learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account right now. Click the link in the description. I'll see you next time. Bye! When learning a new language, we sometimes have a hard time with things like procrastination, discouragement, or failure. But don't panic. With a good strategy, you'll be able to overcome these difficulties. Are you ready to discover the four habits of successful learners? Number one, optimize your time. When learning a language, it's important to dedicate time to your studies regularly, even if sometimes it's difficult. You're busy with school, work, family, or friends, but you can spread out your learning throughout the day. Study whenever you have small gaps of time in your busy schedule. This can be when you're on the metro, on your lunch break, or while you're exercising. Our podcast learning format fits perfectly into your tight schedule. Number two, consistency with your chosen method. There are a lot of options when it comes to courses and learning materials. Switching from one method to another can confuse you and disrupt your progress. Focusing on one learning method will make a difference. Our method has been created and optimized by real teachers, so you can stick to it with confidence. Number three, use your language background. Many languages share some commonalities. You can find words that look or sound similar, or even share the same grammar structure. A little bit of language background will give you an edge while learning. Number four, study continuously. People are excited when they start learning a new language. The enthusiasm usually lasts until the first roadblock. This can lead to discouragement and procrastination. But don't burn yourself out. Learning a language is a marathon, not a sprint. Don't try to learn it all at once. Break things down into more digestible chunks. Learning step by step might feel slow, but it's an efficient way to learn a language. With patience, motivation, and good resources, you'll master the language. Remember, you can't learn a language overnight, but with motivation and these daily lessons, you'll be on the road to fluency. Give it a try now. Sign up for your account. Just click the link in the description. Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.